Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to talk about gun jewelry mentality. And what I mean by this is basically, I know a group of people at the range. Now, they're not like the 1911 crew, the wheel gun crew, okay, the 10mm crew, where these are guys that congregate together. It's like a, I don't want to say like a clique per se, but there are a few guys there that I know that treat their handguns like jewelry. And most of these guys, they buy semi-custom 1911s, all right? That's mainly what it is, semi-custom 1911s or some type of pistol that's somewhat rare or interesting or different to even a standard old HK, you know, P7 M8 or a VP9 even, you know, a plastic wonder. And they treat it like jewelry. What does that mean? Jewelry. Well, you guys know what jewelry is. How do I put this? They don't shoot these guns. They don't shoot them. There was a guy at the range that came up to me and said, "Is that a Wilson Combat?" Because I guess he saw the emblem there. I said, "Yeah, yeah." He's like, "Oh, can I look at it?" And he's looking at it. He's like, "Wow, that's cool, man. Wow, I can't believe you're shooting it." I said, "Well, why wouldn't I shoot it?" He's like, "I don't know, man. Something like this, you know, you just kind of want to admire." I said, "Well, I do admire it a lot." He's like, "Yeah, but you mean you just want to look at it, you know?" And I says, "Yeah, I look at it all the time. You know, yeah, I'm excited about it." He's like, "No, no, I meant like, this is something you just want to keep on like on the wall and just look at it, you know, post it up there, be proud of it. Oh my God. Oh God, look what's happening to your gun." Guys, I shoot this thing. It has the brass kisses where the armor tuff is coming off right there. I don't know if you can even see that. The finish is, chipped away right at the ejection port. Does that bother me? See that? Does that bother me? No, it doesn't. It doesn't bother me. Now, if it was on there when I got it, yeah, that would bother me. But because I put that there, it doesn't bother me at all because this is made to be shot. And if that happens, so be it. I'm going to keep shooting it. If it goes right down to the bare metal, which I hope it doesn't, hey, I'll send it back to Wilson, get it refinished. You know, Armor Tough is sort of like Cerakote in a way, and this stuff is going to happen. You know, that's just standard old wear. The Armor Tough is chipping away because the brass is kissing that part of the ejection port. Sorry, it's not focusing, but if you can see it right there. And there. So, that's just what happens, guys. If it starts to get holster wear, so be it. It's not a big deal. But this guy was, like, flipping out. He's like, "Oh, my God." He's like, "How does that make you feel? You must feel like shit." That's what his words were. And I told him, "Nah, it's fine with me." And he could not believe I was all fine with that. He's like, "Dude," he's like, "I would be like crying." I'm like, "Come on." You know, at first of all, the guy was joking about everything, but he wasn't. He's like, "Dude, if this was my gun," he's like, "I would be like sending that right back to Wilson. I would file a complaint. Dude, I would force them to send me a new slide," or I'm like, whoa. I was like, "Then I'd be calling up, their customer service and just, you know, reaming them out."
Because of that?
He's like, "Yeah." See, that's unacceptable. I mean, that's what happens. I had my last spare that I had, that area right there was all, now, I mean, the finish wasn't all chipped away, but it was worn right there because the brass kept kissing this area. But like I said, if it was on there before I even owned it, well, then we got a problem. But because I put that there, it's not a big deal. So, gun jewelry mentality, I mean, look at this revolver here. It's got wear all over it, you know? So, it's interesting because these guys that are, like, into gun jewelry, it's a weird, different mentality, which I don't understand. There's some other guy at the range that has a Nighthawk Custom that he doesn't shoot. So, I'm thinking to myself, why get these, you know, finely tuned, they are works of art, you know, highly functioning machines, and not use them? If I'm doing it to this pistol, I'm okay with that because that's normal wear and tear. Like I said, if it comes from an FFL like that, we got a problem. But these guys are like aghast. Like, "Oh my God, I can't believe you would carry a Wilson Combat." Of course I would carry it. I mean, I know a law enforcement officer right now that carries a Wilson Professional 4-inch on duty. And the thing is banged up to hell. These things are meant to be used. But their mentality is, no, these things are meant to be looked at and admired and enjoyed. Barbecue guns. Another guy I was talking to is like, "Oh, you know, I have an Ed Brown at nighttime. I bring it out." He has a ritual. I think this is kind of interesting. At nighttime, he's a single guy. He's divorced with no kids. At nighttime in his condo, he'll put on his favorite movie or favorite YouTube video, what have you, puts it on the table and just stares at it and he admires it. Says, oh, look at this thing. He'll switch it around, he said, look at this side of it, and he won't shoot the damn thing. But that's what he does every other night. I don't know, I just don't get that. If you get something like this, get out there and freaking shoot the thing and enjoy it. I mean, carry it. If you're confident with it, carry the damn thing, you know? So that's an interesting individual. There's another guy I talked to that does the same thing. He's got his whole gun collection is practically gun jewelry. And he'll bring out a bunch of them at nighttime, you know, while he's single, this guy, and lay them out on the table and just admire them. And that's it, while he's watching TV. I know another guy I talked to, I call him in the gun jewelry crew. He actually, I know this sounds weird, sleeps with it. He goes, remember that old 80s TV show? Was it Sledgehammer? I don't know, the guy's got the revolver on the pillow. So he's got his Colt Python, and he puts it next to him. It's kind of comical in a way, but I guess they are really that proud. But the gun jewelry mentality, I don't have that except for certain Colts that I have that I don't shoot just because they're for collectability's sake. You know, I don't show everything on here, but I have some 1911s that I don't shoot because, you know, they're collectible. But something like this, get out there and shoot this thing, run it hard. If it shows wear, so be it. It's nothing that can't be fixed later on, you know what I'm saying? And that's how I think, but I found it interesting, some of these guys in the gun jewelry crew, how they don't want to shoot their guns and they just want to look at it. I actually have a friend, I wouldn't call him to that extreme, but he has quite a few different 1911s that are semi-custom and even custom that he just never shoots. I met him maybe 2 years ago, but his career or his job is extremely demanding within the medical field. So I guess maybe he doesn't have any time to really shoot, but it's amazing that he's got so many really nice 1911s. He's got a collection of them and he doesn't get to shoot them. And I asked if I could maybe go through them, that collection, and hopefully maybe I could do that. Show you guys what he's got. It's pretty impressive. Stan Chen custom. He's got a Volkman. He's got something from Heirloom Precision made by, what's the guy's name? Jason Burton, I think. So he's got a lot of really nice 1911s, but he just doesn't shoot them. A lot of them have never been shot before, but I think that's more because of his career. Anyways, guys, just wanted to quickly throw that out there about the gun jewelry crew. What do you guys think about that? I don't know. Leave some comments below. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.